Oh, you thought I was making out with somebody? Acting! Those are not the kind of parents we're talking about. We're talking about these kind of parents. Oh, what's this? Oh my god. You guys are so cute. Oh, you guys can stop it now. I said you guys can stop it now. Oh, freaking me. You never are gonna stop, aren't you? Well, I guess it can't get any worse than this, right? Oh, fuck. Oh my god, what is this shit? What the fuck is coming out of my body? Oh my god! I hate you so much. You rub it around some more. Why don't you make it so you never open your legs ever again, you huh? Or anti-hole. And then you go in the bathroom, and you take down your pants, and you go, what the hell is that? So on the first day, it's just like a nice little decoration. Hello. On the second day, it's like a demon party for sacrificing little lambs. And then the third day, it's like, goodbye, that was fun. And you're just left there to die. That's basically a summary. Maybe we should have a little bit more blood clots. There you go. So for a while, I wanted to check out these cups that hold your blood, call them blood bombs, and they basically, you can use them for 12 hours, and they'll never leak, apparently, if you use them correctly. That's the wrapper it comes in. It looks like a humongous condom. But basically, you put that in your body, and it collects the blood for 12 hours, and you can do whatever you want. So there's your whispering eye. You've inserted into your beautiful cave, and you put it behind your pelvic bone, and that's where it's supposed to airlock and sit and collect the blood. I thought this was amazing when I first read about it. It sounded like the salvation that us women, females, in this world needed. I don't know how they lived away back then. I don't even want to know. But yeah, I thought this was going to be our holy grail. But after using it, no. It was definitely like a slaughterhouse. So I've decided that, you know, if ever we need a bioterrorism weapon to use against attackers, terrorists maybe, we could always use these to get out of our vagina. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna say it, vagina. And just, you know, hit them with it. There you go. Who else is disgusted? So tampons measure by grams of how much blood they hold, but cups measure, I think, by volume. So I just wanted to really know how much it was. So there's a quarter of a cup of blood. And so I put it in the cup, and it's a quarter of a cup. It fits perfectly. I do it again just, you know, to reiterate, because I'm a scientist, and this is for science. How to make the blood. Had to make it red. So it's perfect. It's a quarter of a cup of blood. I don't know. I think I lose that in like 2 or 3 hours on my best day. But the cup is definitely much more effective, I think. With a tampon, simple. You insert it into the vagina. You push a stick in it while keeping the placement in the vagina. Then you pull both of them out, leaving the cotton tube inside. This is me testing absorbency of the tampon. It's actually pretty absorbent, but definitely the cup wins by holding the liquid. I definitely cannot use tampons on my best day. So there you go, those are the three weapons of your choices, ladies. Which one do you choose? Stay tuned for our belly button day!
I am not a whore. 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 I am not a whore.
But I like to do it.